The history of the old American West is full of stories of gunmen, cowboys, Indians, and lawmen. But some have become famous, and their characters have become true Western legends. William Bonney, better known as Billy the Kid, is one of the most famous criminals in history. With his youth, audacity, and violence, his deeds continue to be told today. Despite earning fame in the Wild West, Billy was born in New York in 1859, where he lived his childhood. His baptismal name was Henry McCarthy. With the death of his father, the family moved to Indiana, where his mother remarried. Then, they moved to the West. But when Billy was 14, his mother died of tuberculosis in New Mexico. Orphaned, Billy began to commit petty crimes. Together with a friend, he ended up in jail for theft. The prison bars were unable to hold Billy for long. The boy escaped the arms of the law for the first time. William Bonney fled to Arizona, where he became a horse thief. It was there that he committed his first murder. Billy got involved in a bar brawl with a local bully, the blacksmith Francis Cahill. During the fight, the boy was thrown to the ground. To prevent Francis from stealing his gun, Billy shot him in the belly. Some witnesses said it was an act of self-defense, but Billy was accused of murder. The young man returned to New Mexico but almost died in the desert when the Apache Indians stole his horse and left him on foot in the desert. On his return to New Mexico, Billy was hired by the Englishman John Tunstall, an emerging cattle baron who treated Billy with respect, something unusual in his life. But the Englishman had a huge conflict with the economic elite of Lincoln County. Tensions between rival groups rapidly increased. In 1878, John Tunstall was murdered by gunmen hired by his rivals. Part of the population and Tunstall's men demanded justice. But the men of the law, including Sheriff William Brady, were bought by Lincoln's elite. To avenge their boss's death, Billy the Kid, his mates, and some Lincoln citizens created an armed group known as the Regulators. It was the beginning of the Lincoln County War. The Regulators hunted down the men responsible for John Tunstall's death. Billy and his companions were eliminating one by one the boss's executioners, including Sheriff Brady and his deputy, subservient to the local elite. Both were killed in an ambush. On June 14, 1878, a major shooting took place between the Regulators and the forces of the new sheriff, George Pepin. This conflict became known as the Battle of Lincoln. The shooting in the city lasted about 5 days. The Regulators seemed to have the upper hand, but the sheriff received reinforcements. Soldiers from Fort Stanton's army cornered Billy and his companions in a building. The building where the Regulators were entrenched was fully surrounded and set on fire to force the gunmen out. Billy the Kid volunteered to attract the attention of the soldiers and citizens surrounding the building, creating a small window of opportunity for his colleagues to escape. Many of his colleagues died in the Battle of Lincoln, but Billy and some friends managed to escape alive. Due to the large number of people involved in the Lincoln County War, a large amnesty was decreed for the crimes perpetrated during the conflict. But Billy's name was not among the amnesty recipients. He was considered a wanted outlaw. Billy the Kid tried to negotiate his amnesty with Governor Lew Wallace, promising to testify in the case of the barbaric murder of a renowned lawyer. William Bonney turned himself in to the authorities and testified before the jury as arranged. However, the promised amnesty did not happen. Billy was arrested, but escaped again. News about Billy the Kid were scarce for some time, but he couldn't stay out of trouble for long. In a saloon in New Mexico, a man seemed to be watching out for Billy. The boy noticed his restlessness and approached him friendly, praising the man's beautiful weapon. Billy asked to see that gem and the guy accepted. William Bonney realized that the gun had 3 bullets and gave it back to the man. The man pointed the gun treacherously to Billy's head and fired. But the smart boy had changed the position of the revolver drum. One of the empty cylinders of the gun was triggered. Billy the Kid showed no mercy and shot the aggressor in the head. New Mexico's governor established a $500 bounty hunt for anyone who captured the criminal William Bonney and brought him to justice. Quickly, Lincoln's new sheriff, Pat Garrett, took over the mission to capture Billy the Kid. The sheriff and his men managed to corner Billy and his remaining companions and bring them to justice, where they would be tried and sentenced to hang for the death of Sheriff Brady. Everything indicated that this would be the end of the brave gunfighter. Under the constant vigilance of two delegates, the hanging seemed like a sure fate. But using his cunning and violence, Billy managed to escape again, leaving two more victims behind. But Sheriff Pat Garrett was determined not to allow this boy to escape again. There were rumors that Billy was hiding in the house of a friend in common with the sheriff. Pat Garrett set up the ambush. During the night, Billy entered his friend's house and saw a man in the shadows. In Spanish, the boy asked who was there. When he recognized Billy's voice, the sheriff shot the outlaw in the chest. It was the end of the most famous bandit of the Old West. Billy the Kid was only 21 years old. The young bandit's fame had already spread throughout the United States. The legends about him further increased the myth of the young gunman. In the following decades, dozens of books and movies told of the young gunslinger's adventure, often portrayed as a hero. Even with such a short career, Billy the Kid left his mark on history. He is a true legend of the Old West.